Basic thermodynamics class. So in the first chapter, that is the fundamentals of thermodynamics and perfect gas laws. So today is the last class for the first chapter. So we will solve some problems on the fundamentals of thermodynamics and the perfect gas laws. And just we recollect all the formulas what we learn in the each chapter, and we summarize the definitions and the problems whatever we learn in the first chapter. So before going to solve the problems, just we recollect all the formulas what we learn in this chapter. So first coming to the first formula is an absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Next formula is the absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure minus the vacuum pressure. So all of you know that what is in a gauge pressure and what is in a vacuum pressure. So what is in a gauge pressure means that the pressure which is measured by an instrument and above the atmospheric pressure is called as a gauge pressure. Whereas is the coming to the vacuum pressure, the vacuum pressure is less than that of a atmospheric pressure, less than the atmospheric pressure, and it is pressure which is inside the container is less than the surrounding temperature. So these first two formulas gives the relation between the absolute temperature, atmospheric temperature, and the gauge pressure. So this is absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure minus vacuum pressure. So here is a conversion. So basically we have to know what is about the, these are the units of the pressure. So all you know that what is the pressure. So pressure is nothing but the force per unit area is called the pressure. So whatever the force acting on the pressure acting on the surface is nothing but the force per unit area of a surface is called the pressure. The SI units of the pressure are the pascals. SI units of the pressure are pascal, and we know that 1 pascal is a 1 newton per meter square. And here is a these are the bar, atmosphere, mm of mercury are the additional units of the pressure. So how will you convert this? So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. That is equal to, I am writing this 10 power 5 as a 10 square into 10 power 3. I am writing this 10 power 3 as a kilo. Kilo means 10 square, kilo newton per meter square. So we know that 1 newton per meter square is equal to pascal. So it becomes as a 10 square kilo pascals. So 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square is equal to 10 square kilo newton per meter square or 10 square kilo pascals. Like that, 1 atmosphere is equal to the standard atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 mm of mercury. So that is equal to 1.01325 bar. So this, you know that bar is again 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square or 100 kilopascals or 100 kilo newton per meter square. So I am writing this 1.01325 bar as a 101.325 bar kilo newton per meter square. So another formula is also for there where H, height of the liquid column in meters is given. Then we will write that the pressure P is equal to rho G H. P is the intensity of the pressure, rho is the density of the fluid, G is the acceleration due to gravity, H is the height of the column. So whenever the height of the column is given, how to calculate the intensity of pressure means by using the formula P is equal to rho G H. P is equal to rho G H, where rho is equal to density of the fluid, G is the acceleration due to gravity, H is the height of the liquid column. So the coming to the next formula, this is a specific volume. Specific volume is nothing but this is a ratio of the volume of the fluid by the mass of the fluid. So units are for the units, volume units are meter cube, mass units are kg. So the units also meter cube per kg. So specific volume V is equal to volume by mass meter cube per kg. So density. Density is nothing but the next formula, density. Density is nothing but the reciprocal of the specific volume. So we can, I am writing the density with the symbol of a rho. It is denoted by a symbol of a rho. So rho is equal to reciprocal of specific volume. So specific volume is represented by V. So specific volume is represented by small v. So small v is equal to, we know that, volume by mass. So this is a reciprocal, means it becomes as a mass by volume. So units are kg per meter cube. Density is equal to kg per meter cube, like this. The heat transferred from 1 to 2. Heat transferred from 1 to 2 means in nothing but the integral 1 to 2. Integral 1 to 2 dq. Integral 1 to 2 dq. Integral 1 to 2 dq. So work done W1 to 2 is equal to integral V1 V2 is equal to P dV. So we can write this by removing this integral. We can write this also like a du is equal to P dV. dW is equal to P dV, and change in volume I am writing as a V2 minus V1. So these V2 minus V1 is a change in volume, that is nothing but the swept volume. It is nothing but the swept volume. The swept volume is nothing but the area into length. So I am writing that the area as a pi by 4 d square. L is the length of the stroke. So where is the diameter of this cylinder? L is the length of this stroke. So this also very important, students. So in conversions also, all of you all know, but just I am reminding you. So 1 centimeter is equal to 10 mm. 1 mm is equal to 0.1 centimeter. So bring this 10 into this side, it becomes a 1 by 10. 1 by 10 means nothing but the 0.1. So 1 mm is equal to 0.1 centimeter, like this. So 1 meter is equal to 10 power 3 mm or 1000 mm. You can write 10 power 3 as a 1000 also. So I want from this, I want from mm into meter. Mm into meter. So 1 mm is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 meters. 10 to the power of minus 3 meters. So 10 to the power of minus 3 we can write as a 0.001 meter. Like 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. So minus 2 we can write as a 0.01 meters. So these are the conversions while if the problems are given. How to convert the centimeters into mm. So before solving the problem, see how to check all the units should be in either mm or meters or centimeters. So you should have to follow from step 1 to step last, from starting to ending, all the units should be in same means either in meters or mm or centimeters. So for that conversion, this table is very important. So every student should have know how to convert this 1 centimeter and 1 mm, next 1 meter into 1 mm, 1 mm into meter, and 1 meter into how many centimeters, and 1 centimeter into how many meters. So this is a very important point. Every student should be careful to solve the problems first step to last step. All the units should be in either mm or meter or centimeter. So some more formulas are also there. In the next slide we will see. Cv is equal to, so Cv is nothing but the specific heat at constant volume. So here they are taking as a volume as a constant. That's why I am writing as a Cv is equal to dq by dt. So here heat transfer at constant volume with a change in temperature means dq is equal to Cv dt. So change in heat transfer, you can write this as a Q2 minus Q1 and dt as a T2 minus T1. Cv represents a change in specific heat at constant volume. Next, Cv is equal to du by dt at volume constant. Here is another one. So internal energy, heat transfer and the internal energy both are equal at the constant heat transfer or at constant volume. So dq is equal to du is equal to Cv dt. So if you consider the mass per kg, then the formula we can write as a dq is equal to du is equal to mcv dt. dq is equal to du is equal to mcv dt. u2 minus, So here I am writing this as change in internal energy. Change in internal energy means U2 minus U1 MCV T2 minus T1. So this is a very important. The heat transfer and the change in internal energy equal at the constant specific heat at constant volume. Specific heat at constant volume. dQ is equal to CV dT. dU is equal to CV dT. So coming to the next, we are taking the specific heat at constant pressure. Cp is equal to dq by dt. So dq is equal to Cp dt, or while considering the pressure as a constant, otherwise it is equal to the enthalpy. So enthalpy we are denoting with a h. So dq is equal to dh is equal to mcp t2 minus t1. So dh is equal to mcp dt. h2 minus h1 is equal to mcp t2 minus t1, where H2 minus H1 represents the enthalpy. Next, so here the adiabatic index also introduced, that we can represent it with a Greek letter gamma. This is one gamma is the ratio of the two specific heats. So what is this? The ratio of the two specific heat C is called an adiabatic index. So there is a ratio of Cp by Cv, where Cp is the specific heat at a constant pressure and Cv is the specific heat at constant volume. So this both, if you know the values of Cp and gamma, by using this relation we can find the Cv value. If you know the Cv and gamma value, so by using the adiabatic index relationship we can find the Cp. So if you know the two values, by using the adiabatic index we can automatically find the another unknown value. Here they given the two values. Cp value for air is a 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. The units are also very important. Cp is equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kg Kelvin and Cv is equal to 0.715 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So by using these two values we can find the adiabatic index gamma value, as a gamma is equal to Cp by Cv, then it becomes a gamma is equal to 1.4. Gamma is equal to 1.4. So these are the some formulas for the thermodynamic system, and some more formulas are also there regarding the zeroth law, first law, second law. So next formulas we in the next slide. So we move on to the next slide. So dq is equal to du plus dw. So here I am writing as a q, change in internal energy, u2 minus u1 plus w. So this equation is also called as a non-flow energy equation. dq is equal to du plus dw, q is equal to u2 minus u1 plus w. This equation is called as a non-flow energy equation. Next, cyclic integral. This integral inside the cycle, so we called as a cyclic integral. Cyclic integral dq. So the cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So this is for the closed system undergoing a cycle. So where the cycle starts, the end also closed, and the cycle also closed at the starting point only. The starting and ending point are the same. So that's why it's called as a closed system undergoing cycle, and we are representing with a cyclic integral. Cyclic integral. Next, so here cyclic integral dq is equal to, if you consider the cycle 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1 process, here 1 is the starting process and 1 is the ending also. So cyclic integral dq we can write as a process q1 to 2, q2 to 3 plus q3 to 1. Like that the work done also. So work done is equal to 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1. So finally the closed system undergoing a cycle, so finally these two values should be equal. Finally after adding q1 to q2 3 q3 1 is equal to w1 to w2 3 w3. So we call this as a closed system under a cycle. This is a dq is integral dq is equal to integral dw. Next, thermal efficiency. This is related to the second law of thermodynamics. So thermal efficiency, generally we know that the efficiency is output by input. So what is the output here? The output is whatever the work done by the system is the output, and whatever the heat is giving to the system is an input. So net work done divided by the heat supplied. So net work done means whatever the heat we are giving is not completely converted into the work. So some amount of the heat is going on, some amount of the heat is going on, and the remaining heat is called as a net work. So I am writing these net work as a heat supplied minus heat rejected by heat supplied. Simply we can write is this a Q suffix S minus QR divided by QS, or simply Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. So thermal efficiency is nothing but the net work done by the heat supplied. So whatever the work done by the system divided by whatever the heat given to the system is defined as the thermal efficiency. So whatever the work done means, so what the heat given to the system is not completely converted into the work done here. So net work divided by heat supply, I am writing the net work as a heat supplied minus heat rejected divided by heat supplied. So in terms of Q1, Q2 means Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. Next, COP of the heat pump. COP of the heat pump. COP is nothing but the coefficient of performance of heat pump. HP means heat pump. So useful output by required input as a work. Required input as a work. So useful output is a Q1. Required input as a work as a W. Next, coming to the perfect gas laws. So in that, first statement is a Boyle's law. So what's the Boyle's law? States that at constant temperature the pressure is directly proportional to the volume. At constant temperature the pressure is directly proportional to the volume. So by removing the proportionality constant, just I will put the here this P is inversely proportional. So it is not the P directly proportional. P is inversely proportional to the 1 by V. P is inversely proportional to 1 by V. So these V is in denominator, goes to this side, becomes a PV, and removing the proportionality constant, so it becomes as a PV is equal to constant. So it is a P is inversely proportional to the volume. So here V is in a denominator, so we cross multiply, it will get it's a PV is equal to constant. Removing the proportionality proportionality, just I will putting as a constant, PV is equal to constant. So at state 1 to state means we can write this equation as a P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So P1 is at initial state and P2 V2 is at final state. P2 V2 is at a final state. So coming to the next law, that is a Charles law. Charles law, what is the Charles law? Stating that at constant pressure the volume of the gas is directly proportional to the temperature. So volume is increasing, the temperature is goes on increasing. So here, because the both the volume and temperature are directly proportional, so I am removing the proportionality constant and this temperature is comes to the denominator. Finally, it becomes as a V divided by T is equal to constant. V divided by T is equal to constant. V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. So, this equation is called as a Charles law. This equation is called as a Charles law. So, we can also write this Charles law as a putting as a volume as a constant. So, pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. So P by T is equal to constant. P by T is equal to constant. You can write this equation as a P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2, or V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Next, coming to the characteristic gas equation, PV is equal to MRT. So our ideal gas equation also we called as a, for the two states I am writing this is a P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. So this is the ideal or characteristic gas equation. Next, relation between the specific heats and the gas equation, gas constants. So specific heats, what are the two specific heats, Cp and the Cv? So already we know that the adiabatic index gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. So from the relation between specific heats and the gas constant, we can write the Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So this is the worst equation, and we know that the Cp by Cv is equal to Cp by Cv is equal to gamma. This is in second equation. So by solving these two equations, we will get the individual values of Cp and Cv. So Cp by Cv is equal to gamma. next CV is equal to R divided by gamma minus 1 or CP is equal to gamma R by gamma minus 1. So these are the relations between the specific heats and the gas constant and the adiabatic index. If you know the two values of the specific heats, we can calculate the adiabatic index. We can calculate the adiabatic index. This is the formulas based on a perfect gas loss. So just some more problems we will solve before going to the next chapter. So these problems are important for the 5 marks question. In the last classes I didn't discuss these problems. I discussed about only little shorter problems, and coming these in this class we will solve some bigger problems. So first problem: a system executes a cyclic process as follows. So they given one cyclic process at point 1. So cyclic process means cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So at point 1, 20 kilojoules of heat is supplied and 3 kilojoules of work is done by the system. 20 kilojoules of heat is supplied and 3 kilojoules of work is done by the system at point 1. Next, at point 2, 20 kilojoules of heat is rejected and 5 kilojoules of work is done by the system. 2 kilojoules of heat is rejected and 5 kilojoules of work is done by the system. Next, 15 kilojoules of heat is supplied and 9 kilojoules of work done by the system. And the sign conversions are also very important for solving the problems. So at 4, 5 kilojoules of heat is supplied to the system and 5 the work is done at the fourth part. So in this problem they clearly mentioned is a cyclic process. Cyclic process means cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. We have to apply the cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So first heat transfer during the 4 points. So they given the first one is heat supplied, second one is heat rejected, third one heat supplied, fourth one heat rejected. So whatever the heat giving to the system is positive and whatever the heat is coming out from the system is negative. Heat rejected from the system is negative. Heat supplied is positive, heat rejected is negative. So after reading the question, I can write these questions as I am representing Q1 as a plus 20 kilojoules, Q2 as a minus 2 kilojoules, Q3 15 kilojoules, Q4 5 kilojoules. Like that also work transfer during the points also. Here is opposite to the Q. So W1 is equal to 3 kilojoules, W2 5 kilojoules, W3 9 kilojoules, W4 question mark. So and the given it is in a cyclic process. Cyclic process means cyclic integral dq means q1 plus q2 plus q3 plus q4 is equal to cyclic integral dq. Next, cyclic integral dw is equal to w1 w2 w3 w4. So we know the values of a 1 2 3, but we don't know the value of W4. In the question they asked calculate the W4 value only. According to the first law of thermodynamics, so cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. Cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So cyclic integral, the process is 1 2 3 4. So 20 plus minus 2 plus 15 plus 5 W1 3 5 9 plus W4. So 20 here plus into minus, it is a minus. Plus into minus is it is minus. So 20 minus 2 18. 18 plus 15. 18 plus 15 plus 5 38. 38 is equal to 17 plus W4. 38 is equal to 17 plus W4. We want W4. So this is a positive only. I am putting here only I am bringing these 17 to this side. So it becomes 38 minus 17. 38 minus 17, it becomes a 21 kilojoules. So here there's a work done comes up positive. So positive means we can write as a work is done by the system. Work is done by the system. If work is done by the system. So clearly in the problem they mentioned it is in a cyclic integral. Cyclic integral means nothing but the cyclic process. So cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So after reading the question, write carefully what is a q1, q2, q3, q4 with proper sign convention. So heat supplied means plus, heat rejected means minus. So work done by the system, and they given as a work done by the system. Work done by the system means all are positive only. All are positive only, and we got the answer also positive only. So I am writing the work is done by the system. Work is done by the system. So this is the problem related to the first law of thermodynamics and a closed cyclic process. So we will go to the next slide and solve the one more problem in this model only. Here, a system undergoes a cycle composed by four processes and the energy transfers are tabled below. So the process heat, so they given the table is a process, is a cyclic process 1 to 4. So first process is 1 to 2, second process 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. So in this they given the heat transfer, work done and internal energy, and see that the units are in kilojoule per minute, not in seconds. Now the units are in kilojoule per minute. So all the three units are in kilojoule per minute only. So they some columns and are the empty. So they asked that question, we have to complete the table and determine the rate of work in kilowatts. Determine the rate of work in watts. So for the each process, so we have to calculate. For the 1-2 process, they given that for the 1-2 process they given Q and W. So by using these two values, we can calculate the DU value. So for the process 1-2, DQ is equal to DU plus DW. 1-2 process, DQ is equal to DW plus DU. So they given as a DQ value, 550 is equal to 230 plus DU. So 550 plus is equal to 230 plus DU. So we will get the DU 1-2 process. DU 1-2 process we got as a DU 550 minus 230. This 230 goes to the left hand side, it becomes as a 550 minus 230. So it is a 320 kilojoule per minute only, because this 550 is a kilojoule per minute, this 320 is also, 230 is also in kilojoule per minute only. So we will get the DU12 is also in 320 kilojoule per minute. So in the first column 1-2 process, we got the values of a DQ, DU and W value. So coming to the second process, now we have to move to the second process, that is 2-3. So 2-3. So Q223 is equal to W223 plus DU223. So in the second process, they've given the Q value and W they didn't given. You have to find that and the DU value. So we know the two values. 230 is equal to Q223 is equal to 230 is equal to W. They didn't given the W value. You have to calculate the W value. W 2 to
3, W 2 to 3 plus, they given the DU value as a 380. They given is a 380. 380. So we will get the, bring this 380 to the left hand side, bring this 380 to the left hand side, becomes a 230 minus 380. So it becomes as a minus 150 kilojoule per minute, minus 150 minute. So next come to the third 3 to 4 process. In the 3 to 4 process, they given only Q value. They given only Q value, they didn't given the W value and the DU value. So simply I am substituting only Q value. So I am putting the side as a equation separately. Next, coming to the 4 to 1 process, in this they given the value of a Q value and the W value. So by using these two values, we can calculate the DU value. 0 is equal to 70 plus DU 4 to 1. So this 70 comes to the left side. So it becomes minus 70. And the units also kilojoule per minute. So DU 4 to 1 is equal to minus 70 kilojoule per minute. So in the table, we will get the all the values. So here the Q 4 to 1, they given 0 value, W 4 to 1 is a 70, and the DU 4 to 1 we have to calculate them. So these 70 comes to the this side, means it is a minus 70, left side means minus 70. So DU 4 to 1 is a minus 70 kilojoule per minute. So in the table we can calculate all the values, expect W 34 and DU 34. So what are the values we calculate? DU 1 to 2 as a 320, W 223 as a minus 150, DU 421 as a minus 70 kilojoules per minute. So write all the values in the table. Write all the values in the table which represent the dashes. So represent. So remaining in 3 to 4 only we have to calculate the W and the DU. So for calculating the 3 to 4 process, by this is a cyclic process. So for a cycle, DQ, cyclic integral DQ is equal to cyclic integral DW. So cyclic integral DQ means I'm writing as a 500 plus 230 minus 500 plus 0. Next, we know that W1, you know the W1 to 2, W2 to 3 and W4 to 1. So 230, and we got the minus 50 from process 2 to 3 is a minus 150, and W3 to 4 we didn't get. And next value 4 to 1 they given as a 70. 4 to 1 they given 70. So only minus 150 we calculated from the process 2 to 3. So all the remaining values they given in the table DW value. And the DQ values also they given all in the table. So we will get the D. So 500, this is 550, not 500. Sorry for the mistake. This is not 500, this is 550 plus 230 minus 500. So this is a 550. So 550 minus 550, 280. It is a 280. And this one is a 150. So finally, so W 3 to 4, 280 minus 150 is a 130 kilojoule per minute only, because every units are in minute only. So we have to write this unit also in kilojoule per minute. So this is the W 3 4 is also, we know the W 3 4 also, simply substitute the W 3 4 value in the table. So we got W 3 4 also, and you remaining one is U DU 3 to 4. So for the cyclic process also, DU is equal to 0. So 320 plus 380 minus 630 plus 70 is equal to 0. So this is minus 630. So minus 630 where you get, and by substituting this in the equation 3 to 4 process, here already 5 minus 500 is there. So you got the value W3 to 4 as a 130. So minus 500 minus 130 becomes a minus 630. Minus 500 minus 130 becomes a minus 630. And I have to check, if you want to check what the answers you got correct, as I say, you know the cyclic integral du is equal to 0 means, so check 320 plus 380 minus 630 minus 70 is equal to 0. So all the answers are correct. Like this. So these are the values we calculated. Whatever the dark highlighted, minus 150, 130, minus 630, minus 70. These highlighted values are we calculated from using the cyclic process dq, cyclic integral dq is equal to dw. And they asked there's a rate of the work done. Rate of the work done. So rate of the work done is nothing but the 280 kilojoule per minute. Rate of the work done is nothing but the 280 kilojoule per minute. So 280 means how will you write the 280 in the rate of determine the rate of work in kilowatts. So rate of kilowatts means 280 kilojoule per minute. So I'm writing, we converting this minute into the seconds. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Here observe that the many students do mistake. Here they simply multiply 280 into 60. This is not, this is correct. Here the minute is in denominator. So you have to convert the denominator only. So here 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 280 divided by 60. 280 divided by 60. So it given as a 4.667 kilojoule per second. So 1 joule per second is nothing but the watt. So they ask the rate of work in kilowatts. That's why I am converting 1 joule per second is equal to 1 kilowatt. So I am writing just here. 1 joule per second is nothing but the watt. 1 joule per second is nothing but the watt. So that's why I am converting that kilojoule per minute into the seconds. So yes, 230 plus 130 plus 70 minus 150 becomes as a, by calculator we can get this as a 280. Is a 280. So converting into the minute into the seconds, we will get as a joule per second. Already kilo is there, so 4.667 kilo joule per second becomes kilowatt. So this problem is very important for the 5 marks question. So first read the question carefully and write the data, and by using the first law of thermodynamics calculate each process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 1. And next apply the cyclic process dq is equal to dw and calculate the remaining unknown terms. After that fill the table, and finally the second question also they ask calculate the rate of work done. So rate of work done is 230 minus 150 plus 130 plus 70 becomes as a 280 kilojoule per second, kilojoule per minute. So I am converting this minute into the seconds. 280 divided by 60, 4.667 kilowatts. I am writing here, so 1 joule per second is equal to 1 watt. 1 watt. This is the problem. So next we move. So a closed system undergoes a cyclic process. Heat and work transfers are given below. Prove that the tabulate results are the consistent with the first law of thermodynamics. Also find the thermal efficiency of the cycle. So here again the closed system undergoes a cyclic process. This also cyclic process dq is cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So the heat and the work transfers are given below. Prove that the tabulate results are considered first law of thermodynamics. Calculate the thermal efficiency. So heat supplied, heat rejected and heat supplied. And here the work done by the system, 0 on the system, 0. So process, according to the first law of thermodynamics for cyclic process, cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral dw. So dq is equal to 30 minus 28 minus 16 plus 19. So we will get as a 5 kilowatts. 5 kilowatts. Next, dw is equal to 5. So both are the same. So this is a violates the accepts the first law. So because dq is equal to dw. So as the given data is consistent with the first law of thermodynamics, so we can say because the both the values are same, 5 kilowatts, 5 kilowatts. So we can say that the given data is consistent with the first law of thermodynamics. So calculate the efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but the work done by the heat supply. So what is the work done here? Total is a 5. Work done is a 5 kilowatts. And heat supplied. So here the heat supplied only positive values. Positive values represents the heat supplied. Negative value represents the heat rejected. So what are the positive values? 30 and the 19. So heat supplied is equal to 49. So 49 is the heat supplied. Efficiency is equal to net work by heat supplied. 5 divided by 49. So it becomes as a into 100. This becomes as a 10.2%. So next problem is a closed system undergoes a cyclic process. The heat and work transfers are given below. Fill the missing quantity. Comment whether the work is done on the system or by the system. So if you get the value positive, we have to write the comments. If you get the negative value, we have to write the comments also. And this is a closed system. The heat and work transfers are given below. And missing is a D2A, work done in D2A. So in cyclic integral DQ is equal to cyclic integral DW. So cyclic integral DQ is equal to 24 minus 8 plus 10 plus 9. Is equal to 4 minus 2.2 plus 4 plus WD2A. According to the first law of thermodynamics for the cyclic process, cyclic integral DQ is equal to cyclic integral DW. So DQ is equal to, already I told, 30 minus 28 minus 16 plus 19 is equal to 35 kilowatts. So DW. So DQ is equal to DW means we will get the value 29.2. As it is a positive, the work is done by the system. If it is a negative value, the work is done on the system. You have got the positive value means the work is done by the system. So go, if you practice the problems frequently, then every problem should be easy, and the time saving also are very important to solve the problems. Next, 0.2 kg of gas is subjected to change of temperature from 15 degree centigrade to 180 degree centigrade at constant pressure. Find the heat transfer, change of internal energy and change of enthalpy. If the specific heat at constant pressure is 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, adiabatic index is 1.4. 0.2 kg of mass. So first write the given data. So mass is equal to 0.2 kg. Change in temperatures. So T1, T2, they given in T1 and T2 as a 15 degree centigrade, T2 180 degree centigrade. Find the heat transfer. So we have to calculate the DQ, change in internal energy, DU, and enthalpy, DH. And they given the specific heat at constant pressure, CP value. CP value is equal to 1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin and adiabatic index 1.4. So M is equal to 0.2, T1 15 degree centigrade, T2 180 degree centigrade, CP 1.0 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, gamma 1.14. So you know the CP and gamma value. By knowing these two values, we can calculate the CV value also. CV is nothing but CP by gamma. So is equal to 1 divided by 1.4 is equal to 0.714 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So here the heat transfer. So it is a heat transfer formula at a constant pressure. Q is equal to MCP T2 minus T1. MCP T2 minus T1. So we got this is 33 kilojoules. So like the change in internal energy, DU is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So we got the change in internal energy as well. So substituting all the values in the given formula. So M is equal to 0.2 into 0.714 into 180 into minus 15 is equal to 23.562 kilojoules. Because here they given the CP value in the kilojoules, and we also take this CP value and the CV value in kilojoules per kg Kelvin only. So that's why we get answer in kilojoules only. So we got the heat transfer and a change in internal energy. These are the
problems related to the first chapter, that is the thermodynamics and the perfect gas laws. And students, you can do some more problems for more practice. So this is the first chapter. So in the first chapter we discuss about the, just I summarize them, whatever we discuss in the this chapter. So in this chapter means, first we discuss about the system. System means, system in the region in the space containing a matter whose behavior is to be investigated. So next means, in the system also surroundings and the boundary also we discussed about. Next, the properties of the system are intensive properties and the extensive properties. Next, coming to the process. This process may be defined as a here the system is changing from the one state to the another state. Before writing the process, we can define the state also. The state means to which the system passes, the system moves during the process, is called the path of the process. Path of the process. And the heat and work also important, and the sign conventions of the heat and work. So mainly heat is done due to the temperature difference, and the work is due to the pressure gradient. Heat is due to the temperature difference and the work is due to the pressure difference. So some sign conventions are also there for the heat and the work. Heat and the work, some sign conventions are also there. If heat is supplied, we can take it as a positive. If heat is rejected, heat is rejected means it can taken as a negative. So work done by the system, work done by the system is positive, work done on the system is a negative. Work done on the system is a negative. Then next, coming to the thermal equilibrium. So thermal equilibrium is for the zeroth law of thermodynamics. So thermal equilibrium means, if A and B are in, when we'll said that the system is in thermal equilibrium, so that the properties of the system will not vary themselves, and all the property at the temperature are constant. So that is the thermal equilibrium. So zeroth law means states as, zeroth law means that the, so when two bodies are in thermal equilibrium with a third body, they are in thermal equilibrium with each other. Like A equal to C, B equal to C means automatically A equal to B. This is a zeroth law. Coming to the first law means, first law is mainly based on the heat and work are mutually convertible. Heat and work are the mutually convertible. So in these two definitions we can tell. So in these two cases we discussed. One is for the cyclic process and one is for M. dQ is equal to non-flow energy equation. Non-flow energy equation means dQ is equal to dU plus dW. So for the non-flow process, the first law can be written as a dQ is equal to dU plus dW. For the cyclic process, we can write as a cyclic integral dQ is equal to cyclic integral dW. So where the Q is equal to heat supplied in kilojoules, a W is equal to work transfer in kilojoules, and we discussed as the limitations also. So from these limitations only, the second law is defined. So second law, the two scientists gave this. One is a Kelvin Planck and another one is a Clausius. So what the Kelvin told, it is an impossible. So Kelvin statement, it is an impossible to construct a device that operates in a cycle and produce no effect other than to receive heat from the single reservoir and convert to equal amount of the work. In simple words, so there is a no engine. So whatever the heat given, that is not completely converted into the work. Means here, whatever the, suppose if I am giving the heat supplied as a QS and work done as a W, so Kelvin is telling that whatever the heat supplied is not completely converting into the Q. Some amount of the heat should be rejected. Some amount of the heat must be rejected. So that's why it is impossible to construct an engine, that is QS, heat supplied is equal to the work done. So this is the Kelvin statement. And the Clausius statement, what's the Clausius telling? Heat cannot be flow from your body at a lower temperature to another body at a higher temperature without any aid of external energy. So the temperature of the low body cannot be flow to the temperature of the higher body. So this is the second law of thermodynamics. So next, coming to the Boyle's law. What's the Boyle's law is telling? That At constant temperature, the pressure of the gas is inversely proportional to the volume. As the pressure increases, volume decreases, or vice versa. Volume increases, pressure decreases. But PV is equal to constant. For all the process, PV is equal to constant. Next, like the Charles law also. So what is the Charles law? I state that at constant pressure, the volume is directly proportional to the temperature. So volume increases, temperature increases. I like this. If you kept the volume as a constant, pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. So if the pressure increases, temperature is also increases. Next, this is the characteristic gas equation. PV is equal to MRT. R is the characteristic gas equation, gas constant. So units are kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Next, universal gas constant is represented with RU. RU. R suffix U, that is nothing but the product of M into R. M is nothing but the molecular weight and R is the characteristic gas equation, the standard value. It is a unit, it is same for all the gases. You have to remember that the value is a 8.314 kilojoule per kg mole Kelvin. 8.314 kilojoule per kg mole. Next, two statements also there. One is a Joule's law. Joule's law, what is the Joule's law is also state there. Joule's law states that internal energy of the gas is dependent only temperature and independent on a pressure and volume. So what is it is telling? So the change of internal energy is equal to the heat transfer. dQ is equal to change of internal energy means dU. So we can write the dU as a mCV T2 minus T1. This is the Joule's law. And what is the Regnault's law? So Regnault's law states that the specific heats of a perfect gas remains the constant. Specific heats of the perfect gas always remains the constant. In this, they given that the adiabatic index also Cp by Cv. So Avogadro's law is nothing but the product of the, what is the Avogadro's law said, that the equal volumes of all the perfect gases under the same condition of temperature and the pressure contains the equal number of molecules. In that, molar volume is also there, that is as a product of the molecular weight, and the specific volume is called the molar volume. And next, the relation between specific heats and gas constant. So R is equal to Cp minus Cv and gamma is equal to Cp by Cv. So by using these two equations, we get the Cv is equal to R divided by gamma minus 1, Cp is equal to gamma R divided by gamma minus 1. These are the relation between the specific heats and the gas constant. So with this, we are closing the first chapter, that is the fundamentals of thermodynamics and gas laws. So for the tomorrow's class, just we will start the second chapter, that is the process, thermodynamic process. So this is the continuation of the first chapter only. If you are perfect in the first chapter, then the second chapter should be very easy. So thank you one on one, and we'll see you in the next class.